Welcome to this brief guide on how to use live captions in Windows 11. Do you suffer from a hearing impairment? Or maybe you just prefer to use subtitles whenever you're watching content online? Do you wish that you could do the same thing inside Windows 11? Well, today I'm going to show you how to use live captions to make that a reality. Here I am in the Settings application, and I'm going to use the menu on the left-hand side and select the option for Accessibility. Selecting this is going to show me all of our accessibility options, but today we're going to focus on the Captions option, which is found in the Hearing subcategory. Selecting this will show us all of our Captions options, including the first one there, which is the ability to turn live captions on or off. You can use the radio toggle in the top corner here in order to do so. We won't turn them on just yet because there's a couple of other things I want to go through. The first of which is that there's actually a keyboard shortcut that you can use, which is Windows Control L to turn these captions on or off. And the first time you turn them on, it will need to download the language files for the captions. Using the theme preview at the top here, you can see what your captions are going to look like, and you can adjust them using the caption style settings in the bottom here. There'll be a drop-down menu where you can select from some different preset options, such as small caps, and selecting that will update the theme preview in real time so you can see what they're going to look like. But maybe you want to make a couple of changes to that particular preset. You can do that using the edit button shown here. And in this section, you can adjust many different things, including, for instance, the font color. So I could make the font yellow and my theme preview at the top will update in real time. And then I can maybe adjust the background and change the opacity as well so that I can make it so it's a completely solid black background if that's something that I would prefer. And as you can see in my theme preview, it's all sorted there for me as well. And in order to save those, I can use the text field here and put in a particular name if I would like. I'm just going to leave it as small caps copy for now. And I'm going to jump back to my caption settings. And what you'll notice in the drop-down menu for caption styles, I now have my small caps copy available to me there. If I want to delete any of the ones I've made, I can simply select that particular style and click on the delete button to remove it. And as you can see, I can jump through a few of these different options. So for instance, if you wanted to see what the yellow and blue option look like, you can check that as well. But for the rest of this demonstration, I'll leave it on default. Now that I've got my settings configured, I'm just going to jump over to YouTube. This could be any particular website online if you'd like to. And I'm going to open up a video. And before the video starts playing, I'm going to use that keyboard shortcut Windows Control L to activate my captions. They'll start up at the top of our screen, which is now colored in a border at the top here. And using the settings cog in the top hand corner here, I can choose where I would like these captions to be located using the position option in the submenu here. If I'd like, I can select below screen and they'll be located down the bottom of my display right above my taskbar. The other option that I have available to me is actually to have it in an overlay on top of anything else I have on my display, and selecting this will open it up in the middle of my screen. And just like any other window, I can actually use the edges of the window itself and adjust the size up and down or even the width left and right if I would prefer. Obviously, keep in mind that the smaller you make this, the less subtitles you'll be able to see on the display at any point. Now, the last little things that I can do inside this settings area here is the ability to change what the caption language is going to be. At the moment, you can only see that I have English installed on my device, but if I was to use the add a language option, I can choose to add additional languages. And in the preferences option, I can choose to blank out any profanity. I also have the ability to include my microphone audio if I wish to show subtitles for things that are playing in my local area, like conversations. And then I have the caption style, which will take me back to my settings to adjust the caption styles. And now I can simply choose to play the video, at which point you'll see these subtitles. Welcome to this brief guide on how to record system audio in Windows. And as you can see, that's recorded the subtitles perfectly, but it doesn't work for just web content. I can actually play a local video file that I have as well, such as this one. Welcome to this brief guide on how to record system audio in Windows. And as you can see, the subtitles have been perfect in both accounts. So you can utilize this for any content anywhere, both in your local area as well as on your device. And that is how you use live captions in Windows 11. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your Windows experience just a little bit more accessible. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.